At the Winter Park Mountain Lodge. We're supposed to meet here at 10:45. We're really, really early. It's 10:08 right now, but yeah. We're just gonna go around, maybe take some pictures, maybe go get something small to eat, because we woke up get around like 7 or so, right? And we still haven't eaten. It's been 3 hours. Mm-hmm.
We got Kevin jugging over there trying to look cool in front of his car.
Okay. Video.
We got Joybin jugging trying to be a photographer. Look at our parents.
Yes, it's day two. So today we're going to be snowmobiling. Snowmobiling?
Yeah, snowmobiling.
Yeah, snowmobiling. We have our two drivers.
You already know. Number one driver.
We have Pow Wow, the CDL driver, the professional driver. And then we have another professional driver, Kevin Juggin. And it's snowing. It's so pretty. I love the snow. I can't wait to have a whole freaking photo shoot in the snow. But yeah. We're gonna go grab something light to eat first so we can be ready and prepared for the snowmobile, because that's also another 2 hours on the road, I believe.
It feels good.
Hi, ugly. I'm fine, handsome.
I could take my phone out.
It's snowing.
We're going to ride.
And it's snowing. It's so pretty. Okay, we gotta.
You're supposed to do it the same way as me.
I know. Okay, let's do it again. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go.
Or you be left in the dust, unless I stuck by ya. You're the sunflower, you're the sunflower.
Every time I'm leaving on you, you don't make it easy, no. Wish I could be there for you, give me a reason to. Every time I want.
and it's gonna be single track. We're kind of done with this like wide road.
You have the muscle too?
I got the muscle already in it. I can't do anything.
Sauce is good.
Yeah, it is. That's pretty good. That's really good. You know why? When we were at the airport and you know you guys were trying to find your bags and you guys were like, it's on C9. I'm like, yeah, but let's get on this bus, even though it says AB, maybe it'll take us, you know, over there to the baggage claim. But you know, maybe we get off at once and then we'll just walk. Nobody listened to me. They said, let's go. And then when we get there, nobody wanted to get in the thingy. And then they go up. And then they come back down, and we end up going. And then at the snowmobile, right? And Paul's like, I gotta meet him. And we have said, no, you got 3 times extra large. No, I gotta meet him. I gotta meet him. And then it's like, you sure? Because your head bigger than mine. And I'm like, no, Paul, you got 3 times large, right? Nothing. And then we come back, he takes off his helmet, and he's like, yo, I got 3 times. And then just now, because the whole time we were passing, I was like, yo, there's a Japanese thing here. Nothing. And then today, like a day later, you're like, whoa, there's a Japanese thing here. You guys just don't listen to me.
They don't listen to you.
And then when we get there, you guys are trying to find the breakfast because you guys are hungry, right? And I read the sign, it said, you know, breakfast operates from 8 to 10. And then dinner, and then it reopens up for dinner from 4 to 10. And then you guys still want to go and find it. We go to the second floor.
Bro,
I can't find it.
Yeah, you're just talking to yourself.
No, I think you guys just don't listen to me.
If I had heard you, I would have been like, oh, okay, then just go back. You know, but you know, I didn't hear you. That's why.
You know what? I feel like I don't feel hurt on this trip. So who and Paul want to be a swinger couple?
No, you guys want to be. About, is he married? Does he have kids?
Just admit you want to be a swinging couple with
him. That's you, bro.
Oh, is that right? Huh? This is one of them who don't listen to me on the trip, who just ignore everything I say. And then there's the other one who don't listen to me, who just doesn't listen to me. She's one of them. And then there's another one right here. Who don't listen? This is the other one.
Hey, I do listen.
You know what? I feel very unheard.
No, just a bystander.
Here's this one who thought his head was a size media.
Good
night,
Mike.
So it's day 3 today. We all just woke up. It's 6 a.m. and we're all getting ready to go skiing.
I'm snowboarding.
Hey, everybody else scarf, is skiing. Guys.
And they're all ready as well. Are you ready?
No, I haven't done my makeup yet. I'm gonna do it in the car though.
Can I go like this?
And Paul trying to figure out his outfit, I guess. But we're excited. So Steven's the only one that's gonna be snowboarding and the rest of us are gonna be skiing.
Try to catch the sunrise, but tried. We'll see. Yes, sir. So it ain't that cold out here, to be honest, but so I'm out here. This is our rooftop, our little deck seating patio area. So we got the sunrise still coming up. I mean, it's pretty much daylight already, but yeah, so sunrise coming up out over there, and then the city is actually over here. So just pull it up. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey, boy. Come on, man.
We got to go.
We got to go, Sean.
Full energy today. Ain't wanna chill last night.
Last night, you know, I was ready to stay up all night, but homeboy over here, I done already tapped out off of two drinks.
What'd you have, four?
Okay, you have four.
You were gone. You were like,
I was not gone, bro. On the couch, bro. If there's no proof, then it never happened. So
shit, we got three eyewitnesses.
But homeboy right here tapped out hella early last night. Hey, wanna stay up with us? Ain't that right, babe? Didn't Paul tap out last night?
No, it was you. Stop lying to me.
Nah, bro. See, if there's no proof, then it never happened, bro.
She has a video on her phone.
We on this tunnel, this long ass tunnel here.
I was so tired of vlogging yesterday.
It's all this view.
It's so beautiful.
So we made it here to the Dillon. What's this, Dillon Reserve?
Dillon
Reservoir. Dang, these snows are deep. Super like soft, bro.
Go over there.
But yeah, so we're over here. This is pretty much the whole lake. It's frozen up. And we finna just get some pictures, a couple of pictures, and then we're gonna head out to the next spot. And then from there, we're gonna go straight to go skiing, snowboarding, or whatever else we're gonna do. But man, look at this view, though.
Good view right here. You don't see that.
And surprisingly, it's not that cold. Like, this weather is probably as cold as it is back at home. So I was expecting it to be even worse than that. I'm talking about like frostbite, hands, fingers numb, air, all that.
Yes. Yourself Sapphire Point Overlook, and it was so pretty. We went to two overlooks. It was the Dillon Reservoir and the Sapphire Point Overlook. And the whole lake was just frozen solid. I was like, what? Like, there was snow over everything. I was like, wow, that's crazy. That was my first time ever seeing that. So that was really cool. And then when we were at the Sapphire Point Overlook, there were some pee on the snow. Like every few steps that you took, like it was like yellow snow, and that was not very fun. But we did meet some nice people there. They took some pictures of us, we took some pictures of them, vice versa. They were very nice. So everyone here in this town has been so nice.
You said up there, right here. You gotta go first.
Anyways, hi guys, so we're here at Breckenridge, not Breckenridge, we are here, not yet, okay. We are here at Ski Cooper, we are about to ski, I think we're all skiing except for my diet, so yeah. Right now, I'm just putting my shoes on with the help of my honey, thank you honey.
A water tank over there as well with little cups.
They have hot chocolate too, but not right now. Maybe later when we're done. We can get some hot chocolate when we're done.
Oh, they say you gotta put
it. I'm okay.
Should I buy a Snickers?
All right. So update. Everyone seems kind of cranky. Everyone seems kind of cranky. I think.
I was not cranky.
Anyways, we're here to eat. We got some chili cheese fries here. We did it with her hot dog, of course. Hot dog and spaghetti. I don't know what my dad got, but I got some bacon cheeseburger.
You got chicken sandwich.
And both him and Pawa got chicken sandwich. So, bon appetit.
So we just got back from skiing. Where was this mountain called?
Ski Cooper.
Ski Cooper Mountain. You know, I did the best. Like, I was the best skier. Like, no lie. And like, he did. I took a fall. Snowboarding.
Like a bad fall.
Like, he kept falling. Like, he fell like 4 times in a row. Like, bro, like I my first time there, I didn't even fall. Like, I just went straight down, side to side, all the way down. Now okay, you know that's cap.
Well, I beat you guys at speed. Okay.
Yeah, she hit the top speed right there.
We'll put a clip in on how well he did right now.
Hey, don't do that now.
Don't do me like that.
But anyways, but yeah, I mean, I did okay. That shit was so hard though. I'm probably gonna snowboard.
This is your first
snowboard.
Time, right?
Yeah. I'm probably gonna snowboard next time. If snowboarding is hard, I'm not coming up the mountain no more.
Period.
How was snowboarding, bro?
Snowboarding was good. So, I mean, it was... I would say, at first, it was, you know, kind of hard getting used to it. But then when I went the second time around, I got better at it. At my momentum, how to use my body, like swinging my body side to side. And, leaning back, leaning forward, to kind of stop myself. Yeah, but other than that, it was great. It was my first time snowboarding too. But,
it was yelling at me.
You did good. Yeah, it was good. I would do it again. Do it again for sure.
Yo, these two are back here dying, bro.
Okay, so I had fun. I would do it again. It's just I need to learn how to stop. I feel like that was the one thing that I really really struggled with the most, trying to stop. I just threw my ski sticks away and just, you know, fuck it. But I'll say that I will probably go maybe take some ski lessons first. Maybe go back to Appalachia and try to ski there, because this is way too advanced for me. Their beginner slope is like advanced slope for places like in Appalachian.
But I mean, yeah, overall, I think I would have had a good time if someone wasn't yelling at us. Someone was like yelling at us, they didn't have any patience. They were yelling at me and Paul, and then they pushed me and Paul.
Fucking Paul was getting nowhere. He just got closer to me, dude. Instead of moving forward, he's moving sideways.
And then my thing kept going on top of each other, kept making the X. And it's like, stop doing that! You didn't put your legs straight! You see it? Why are you walking like that? I'm like, so that's what I said. You know what? F it. I'm just gonna go. And I went, and then go with Paul yelling. And then because you go to Paul. And I went, and I just found you. Because I was so done. And I kept telling him to leave me alone. I kept telling Steven to leave me alone. I said, leave me alone. I'm like, just go. I'll do it by myself. No, because if I leave, who's gonna push that? Paul fell after telling me to be careful. And then he fell. I said, when I fell, I just laid there. And don't even come. Don't even come.
I was like, is she gonna get up? I just stared at you. You're just sitting there.
Because I was like, you know, I'm done. Oh, yeah, and here we're going to this man who keep hitting us.
You finna stay in the car.
I'm staying in the car. I don't wanna get my head hit.
I'm going in there. He's gonna be like, hey, where's the other two?
No, tell them the other two didn't.
Knocked out.
Oh my god. And then I have pain in my left side. Oh my god, this thing getting yelled at, you know. Got muscle pain, getting pushed, getting hit on the head. Yo, I've never got it.
Yo, he's getting abused. We're being physically abused today.
Honestly, today is just, you know, it's just abused joy today. That's what it's all about.
Abused joy day too.
But overall, it was fun. You know, I'm glad that, you know, even though I didn't, go down the slope many times. I didn't rush.
You didn't go at all.
Hey, I went down. You just didn't see me. I was zooming.
So we just went and we dropped off our ski rentals, and now we are heading towards downtown Breckenridge just to explore a little bit.
Is the gondola line open?
Gondola should be open. It's open because that's the town's access to the peak. So yeah, and it's also free. And if it's not open, then we can just explore downtown. Okay, so we made it to Breckenridge. Right now they're trying to figure out how to do the public parking. It's really cold, it's snowing. I'm not sure if you can see, but it's snowing here. Let me zoom in on his jacket. Yeah, there you go, you can see it now.
I thought she was on the phone for a second.
Put this one on, huh?
Yeah, we are about to. We're about to go eat at this Thai.
We're eating everything, Thai food. We're finna go get some sushi. It's a Thai place, sushi too?
Huh? Yeah, it's a Thai bistro and sushi bar.
This guy's the most stingy with the car key.
I know!
Toss it to him.
Even early. Yo, something smells fucking good. I'm hungry.
It smells good. What is that?
It smells like Asian mix too.
What in Mother Nature is that?
I think everyone is hungry.
Because I think the Thai place is literally right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, like, I think it is right there too.
Something gotta be like smoking out of the house.
Yeah, what's yeah, right there.
Why Bakuna?
No, it's a good thing.
Oh
right
no,
there.
I gotta pee, bro.
Go over there, bathroom over there then.
Restaurant's over there?
I'm pretty sure it's right there because we drove like that.
Yeah, I was gonna take that way like that. Over there.
To the restaurant?
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. This way is shorter though, right?
I guess, sure. I mean, we can go that way.
Oh, I'm wrong. Don't be listening to me. You go ahead. You made the decision. I don't do wrong.
Okay, let's go. Wrong, let's go.
Where are we going?
We're going to the Asian place.
Going that way? All right, let's just go pee first then. Since we're going up this way, anyways.
Okay. All right.
Might as well check out what's in that building.
You want to check out a pee bath?
It's pretty good, man.
Where? That pepper?
That time.
Oh.
Thought that was pretty good?
Yeah, try some then.
So, we're trying to ride the gondola in Breckenridge, but we got here too late. It was like it closed. I wasn't
this,
really.
TRD Pro?
I wasn't even aware that it closed. But yeah,
yeah.
It did.
Can you picture?
So now we're just gonna go ahead and go home.
I think it's like the 18th.
Very sad. I was really looking forward to the gondola. It's just so beautiful.
How was your overall experience?
It was good. It's great.
I heard you were pretty mad yesterday.
Hmm?
I heard you were pretty mad yesterday.
I wasn't mad, bro.
This old man.
This
is my dad.
This
bro.
Old man told me I was gonna go pro at snowboarding.
Oh shit.
Yeah, that's old. Gonna head to the airport, put our luggage in the car, try to kill some gas on this rental, and finna hop on a plane, go home, take a shit at the airport.
Damn.
All that.
I'm gonna go home sleep.
We wanna go home sleep?
I stay home cook rice.
Okay, stay home cook rice.
You gonna stay home cook rice?
Well, what? Anyway, for me, you know, I'm probably gonna be slacking off
stay
too.
Stay home cook rice?
You know, we got Kevin Jug in here to drive.
Hey,
so
how come
all
you got that
beanie,
not me?
Mother, you know,
you know,
stay home cook
rice. All of us got black on except you two. She didn't get the memo today.
It's because you didn't get the memo yesterday.
And it's okay, because when we first came here, we were her bodyguards, and that's the same thing.
Yeah, that's all right, that's all right. Well, anyways, goodbye, Denver.
Bye.
And goodbye, Colorado. We'll see y'all maybe in next year or a couple years.
Thank you for having us.
We just missed our flight to Charlotte, and she's excited because we're gonna get to go to Dallas. That's why she's so happy.
I'm just going crazy, bro.
She's high off the altitude. And we missed our flight.
It's crazy because remember yesterday we were
in Denver. Y'all need to get y'all train system fixed because we could have made our flight, but y'all made us late.
That train, it took us 2 hours to get from the boarding station all the way to our. To like the
it took
gates.
Us 1 hour just to wait by the train. Just to wait for the train. The whole time we were trying to wait for the train. You know, it looked like train to Busan. Like there's just so many freaking people.
If we get on, you know.
I felt like everyone was standing still, but I just imagined that we're just like trampling on top of each other, trying to get to trying to get to the train. And then, as soon as we got onto the train, right, we got to
B gates.
The B gate. Okay, there's three gates, A, B, C. So we got to the second gate, and so he stepped out to let other people out, and that gate almost closed, and leaving him there. So he tried to step in and almost sliced him in half. Well, not really, but you know. But yeah. They had to pull him in. And I was just laughing. That's what I was laughing about too, by the way.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, oh my god, he almost got sliced in half. Wait, so I'm gonna say what we're doing.
Alright, so our flight got delayed, as we told you guys earlier. And now we're gonna chill here and eat. We got another flight booked to Dallas, which is gonna be right around 12, so we got about an hour to chill, and then from there we're gonna fly from Dallas back home. So we're gonna get home at like 8 o'clock tonight. Probably gonna be closer to 10 because it's delayed. So yeah, so if it's the, so as you can see, we're gonna get wrong. this is what you do when you miss your flight and then you have a delay to the next flight. You just come, get some drinks, have fun, enjoy the moment.
It is what it is.
Yep, it is what it is. Rack up a bill on your uncle and your aunt.
Oh, wait, I got that right here. Rack up paper, scissors, shit. Rack up paper, scissors, shit. Oh, okay, no leaks.
Because we came, stopped by here to get something to eat, something to drink, and Paul didn't want to come in the first place, and now Paul's the one who don't want to leave.
I said one more round of shots. Then we can leave.
But remember when we first got here, he was like, guys, I don't think we should come.
That was because our flight was in 30, 40 minutes. Now our flight is in 2 hours.
Don't you remember? He was like, you guys go ahead, I'll wait here with the bags.
Guaranteed.
We're like, no, come on.
Imagine if I just slipped and he was by there, but
you know. And remember when we got here, he was like, I think we should order the food and go back to our seat. We didn't even have a seat yet. So we should go back. And now we came here, we sat down, we got two drinks in. He's like, want to do one more? How do you feel, Paul? You feel good?
Yes, I am tripping off the dominoes.
You ain't tripping off the dominoes? Just the 8 ball?
Yep, just the 8 ball.
We gonna bar hop? We still got an hour, let's bar hop.
So, I'm feeling good.
Let's go get the...
I'm feeling so good right now. The bar hop again?
Bar hop. Yeah, let's go ahead and bar hop. Something close by.
Mindy, how you feeling, Mindy? Yeah.
Does he got any
I'm
nice
feeling
like,
fabulous.
Fabulous?
Fabulous. Okay.
First God, I'm gonna get a McChicken.
And that cheeseburger, huh? Huh.
Yo, so it's 3 hours from here to Dallas and then another 2.5 hours to home. Wait, no, another 4 hours because we're supposed to get home at 8, 9, right? No, 3 hours, yeah. So 4 hours from here to Dallas and then 3 hours from Dallas to home.
Yes.
Damn.
Hey, here's an update. So we are now waiting to board our plane to go to Texas. And we had missed our initial flight, so we got connecting flight through Dallas. And in 30 minutes we will board. But the thing is, our plane is scheduled to get there at 4:37 or so. And we were supposed to grab the next plane at 5:04, but boarding stops at 4:49.
Flight change at Dallas.
Oh, but yeah, flight. So we get there at 4:37. Our next plane is supposed to be at 5:04, but boarding closes at 4:49. So from 4:37, we have to make it to the gate, to the other gate by 4:49. So.
But you know what's funny? You know who actually made it? You know who's actually on the plane right now?
The
Steven,
lady.
Steven's bag.
Oh, my bag? No, my bag got rerouted.
No, it's probably, look on the air tag. His bag is the only one that actually made it.
I mean, how can I look at the air tag?
Paul has the app.
But he's not close by.
You don't have to be close by, do you?
You don't have to be close by.
So Paul,
you can still see the location.
Steven's in the sky.
Bro, my bag made it before me. We gotta tell Tara to go pick it up.
Damn, so this is how it feels, huh? This is our first time missing a flight. How you feel?
I feel pretty good.
It's actually fun. We got to chill, relax.
You know, I'll see you guys later. I'm about to go get some more beer.
But you know what's funny? What's so funny is that, like, even though we knew, like, the flight, that we missed our flight, it was like 10:21. I don't know why we were running as if the flight was still waiting for us. As if the plane was still like, waiting for
just
us.
Just in case, you know, that like we had some very important people run. Coming along.
I saw Hoot running.
Why is this dude
Steven running?
Bro.
I'm running. Paul running. I'm like,
I just thought maybe because Denver has so many of that, you know, those things happening. Like people just like, missed their flights a lot.
Especially with the train being like that.
Yes. So I thought like maybe they would like, you know, give like maybe extra like 10 minutes or 20 minutes or so. Just to wait. But they didn't.
You trying to call me down there, bro?
Law enforcement officer.
You trying to call me down there, bro?
My dad's an alcoholic, so he's trying to get some more drinks.
Why are you bringing a suitcase?
I'm putting it in front of my seat so nobody take it.
Hey,
hold
buddy.
On, hold on.
You in a damn puffer jacket. Look at all my security bags. Oh, yeah. You know this in there, huh?
Yeah, okay. I'll fuck that up on an airplane.
He can't be an alcoholic by himself, so he gotta get Paul with him.
You both have to go to the bathroom together?
Yo, never have I thought I was gonna be drunk at an airport.
Wait, is your first time?
Like drinking, yeah.
Yeah, because we always make our flight.
Right, when we're at Las Vegas, I'll be trying to gamble. We don't have enough time to gamble because they have the slot machines in the airport.
I thought you messed up. I thought you guys drank at the airport.
He's drunk. He's gone.
That chicken nuggets.
He spills some drink on his shirt as usual.
And he's always wearing a white shirt.
Whenever he's wearing a black shirt, that never happens.
Yeah, but I must smell like an alcoholic.
You want to change your shirt? I'm just kidding.
Excuse me, I'm gonna go pee.
Go ahead.
What?
Them chicken nuggets busting, babe? Good. Them chicken nuggets busting.
Alright, now it's time for us to board the plane to get to Dallas.
We're just waiting in line, getting ready to go.
Ready to go.
Waiting for them to call our group.
Yes, sir.
We're the last group.
Yes. Not last, remember?
Oh, we're second to last.
Second to last, yeah. We're a little bit bougier than that.
Last, we're on the back of the plane.
It's
but
okay.
You know what? It's all good.
In the wild.
Oh, our flight just got delayed.
Oh, again.
She got it. Oh, actually, our flight here to Dallas got delayed. No, we missed the flight because it got delayed.
We missed it again.
Again.
We missed it again.
Okay, and y'all see the rest on media's camera. So, bye.
Okay guys, we got off our flight from Denver to Dallas and we missed that one as well. So now we're just waiting to board for our next one. We're getting ready to board in 11 minutes. But it's, when we got here, Lou and Steven were hungry again. And so they went to go get something to eat. And then, you know, once again, Paul's like, no, I don't want to go. He said, I'm tired. I don't want to eat. Yeah, I want to go sit. But, you know, we didn't even go get something for Lou to eat because she was hungry. He ended up grabbing a chicken sandwich for himself. And he and he was eating.
You got
it. And so, yeah, and so, what a day, right? We missed two flights. We missed our flight in Denver, and now we missed our flight in Dallas, so we had to rebook another one. This is just crazy. How was your food, babe? How do you feel?
It was good.
How do you feel missing two flights?
Honestly, I wasn't ready to go home. Yeah. I'm gonna go to my bed.
At first, I think it was funny when we missed our flight, but then we missed it again.
I'm like,
I'm over. I want to go home now. I want to go home.
All the way across. I don't like that. I don't like that.
So we're just waiting. So we got 10 minutes left until boarding. And yep, I'm pretty sure we're gonna make this one though, guys. I'm pretty sure. At first it was funny, the second time it's not funny.
And I was hungry.
I know, and Paul wasn't hungry, but he said, huh?
Young Papa called me.
That's not nice.
Young Papa called me.
Alright guys, well, see you when we land.